the Fuse Hybrid by UDC. I'm going to give you a link to their Facebook group. UDC stands for Underdog Customs. There's the link if you want to check that out. So, you know, I was actually thinking about that quick click. I don't know if you guys noticed, but I did the pure giveaway at a different time than I did last week. I'm probably going to switch it up every week, so just to mess with people. But anyway, so that's the website. There is the Underground Customs or Underdog Customs group page. So this device, it can take either an 18490 500 or an 18650 battery. It's modular. It has two segments that you can remove and then put an 18500 battery in it if you want to. It has what they refer to as an adjustable battery bed. We'll show that to you here in just a bit. It has Allen key screws in it that we'll show you here in a bit. The top cap, you can actually get two. I'm not sure if that's standard, but that's what came with the one that I got. You've got the acrylic top cap, and then you also get a stainless steel top cap as well. I'll show that close up in a little bit. It's 304 food grade stainless, and it does have the brass segments as well. Bottom firing, it's fully mechanical. The contact points, the positive and the negative, are both copper. And it retails for around $220 to $230. The retail prices, I think, are still being established. You can actually get it from Local Vape in the U.S. You can contact Erica Local Vape, or if you're down in Southern California, you can pick one up at Local Vape. And I think they'll be carrying them in other places as well. So let me vape a little bit of this so I don't get juice all over the place. Ooh. Got used to the cold vape, the warm one hit me. That's okay, Darth Vapor. I know you're in the UK, man. It's fine. I'm you're here every week though, man. I wouldn't be offended if you leave early. Don't worry. All right, so now that I've vaped half the juice that was in there off, let's start off. I'm actually going to just flip autofocus off, and we'll deal with it this way, and we'll do all close-ups. So first of all, let me give you kind of a top to bottom on the device. Switch, it's not recessed. But it's not a problem. We'll talk about that in a little bit. On the bottom, you have an engraving that says UDC, Underdog Customs, and then you have your serial number, and that's the U.S. edition, which may be why it comes with the stainless steel and the acrylic top cap. Then you have your brass segment that's removable, brushed finish. You've got three battery vent holes there. You've got another brass segment. You remove both brass segments for an 18500 battery. Then you have fuse on the acrylic top cap. Single 1mm air hole there. 1mm air hole on the other side. Set up for dual coil. It is designed to be used with dual coil. And then I've got kind of a matching fake true flow ish drip tip that I put in there, and then the stainless steel top cap, same dealy with the air holes, as you can see. It's actually got the same design as well, the same carve outs, and then it's got an engraving that says fuse on the top cap, as you can see there. So let me show you the bottom switch on this guy real quick. So when I first got this, I was kind of Not really thrilled with this. So the way that this telescopes so that it fits any size battery is this Delrin piece here actually screws and unscrews. This is the adjustable battery bed that they were referring to, is this piece of Delrin. So you screw that down, or screw that up, before you screw in the bottom cap, and that is how you get the battery to fit snug without having any issues with battery rattle. Now, you have the copper negative in here, as you can see. And one of the issues that I had when I first was using this device was, all right, well, I adjust the little Delrin piece to get the battery to stop rattling, and I had to bring it up pretty far. And my God, the throw on it was ridiculous. Like, I had to, like, jam my finger up inside the bottom of this thing. You know, I was, like, shoving my finger in it like it was, you know, prom after party. And, I mean, it was ridiculous. And then I thought to myself, well, wait a sec. You know, I don't know if this is an intentional feature or not, but you can actually unscrew that copper negative there to reduce the throw once you adjust this. And I think it is intentional. You know, even though it's not the, you know, it's not tightened down all the way, so I guess it's technically a little bit loose. It stays put. I didn't have any issues with it moving around or with it loosening or tightening or whatever, and I'm still getting good contact and it hits well every time. So you can shorten the throw by unscrewing this switch pin here a little bit so that it loosens up a little bit, and then that makes the throw shorter on it. So you can really adjust the throw however you want to on that. Let's get the battery out. We're going to talk about these a little bit later on too. I finally got the Orbtronics. So, and then you have the brass segments that, like I said, you can take these off if you want to. You take off both of those brass segments, and that'll get you down to 18500 mode. Now, let me show you the bottom connection real quick. Very, very simple. This is the connection point. I believe it's silver-plated copper where it connects to the top of the battery. Okay. With a Delrin insulator, as you can see. And let me put the battery back in, and then we'll talk about how we set this guy up here. So, hold on a sec. I know that I'm not in focus right now. We're going to do more close-up. Let me just take another vape. So, all right, get juice everywhere. Under the hood, you've got pretty high posts on this. I set this up, as you can see, with dual mesh. I really, really enjoy the vape of a mesh setup on a dripper like this. This has kind of become my favorite vape lately. So, and this is set up for dual coil, as you can see. So we set it up with, I think I use 4 wraps of 30 on both sides, and I think it comes out to around 0.8 ohms, if I remember correctly. Pretty straightforward setup. I find that, you know, drippers typically are pretty easy to set up with mesh, as far as like dealing with issues with hot spots and whatnot. It's actually not, I find that you get less hot spots on a dripper because you don't have that shorting that you get with the wick making contact inside the wick hole, which is the common, or the most common cause for top hot spots, actually, is a short inside the wick hole. You don't have that because you don't have a wick hole for it to conduct with. So, and it's got a little bit of a concave juice well down at the bottom there too. And as you can see, like I said, those screws are all screwed in with Allen, with the little Allen key that comes with this guy. This little Allen key. this little Allen key of mine, I'm going to let it shine. So that's what it looks like internally. You know, I think most people are probably going to set this up with silica, and that's fine. It's just personal preference why I set it up the way that I do. So let me put the cap back on. We'll take another vape here. And I'm going to put a little bit more juice in here now that I've emptied it out. So here's the skinny on this guy. So how does it vape? It actually vapes really well. The vapor production's good. I like the draw on it. It's not too airy, which is an issue that I have with a lot of the drippers. I find that the air holes are a little too big, and you get a ton of vapor out of them, but you just don't get the back's bothering me. You just don't get the flavor and the warmth that you do from a tighter draw. But as you can see, the vapor production is very, very good with the dual coil setup. Very, very warm. Quite a bit of flavor. The dual coil obviously helps out with that a lot, with getting that extra flavor. You know, when you have the airflow over both coils, you know, obviously that's going to increase the vapor production and the flavor as well. Issues with the device, the negatives. It took me a little bit to get the hang of the switch set up. Not a huge deal, though. You know, the machining quality on it is good. The biggest issue that I've had with it, actually, is that the air holes on it are really, really low. So, I'm going to show you again real quick. Let me just take autofocus off for one sec. So, if you look at where the air hole is... See that? And I don't have a ton of juice in there right now. And you can see the juice is like right up to where the air hole is there. See the little air hole? Yeah, so I, with mesh, at least, you know, the silica is going to do a better job of holding the juice and soaking up the juice. But when using this with mesh, it is not terribly pocket friendly, which is too bad. Because those air holes are so low. So that's a little bit disappointing. I had some juice leak into my pocket, and I only had maybe 8 drops in there. So, you know, and for a dripper of this size, you should be able to put more in there without having it leak out of the air hole like that. But really, I mean, that's really my only gripe about it, though. You know, I like that you have that acrylic top cap. I think that's kind of cool that you can see the vapor build up in here while you're taking a puff. Here, actually, let me just take autofocus off again one more time, and I just want to show you this close up of it firing. Hold on. Let me get the vapor out of there. You can see the vapor fill up while you fire it. It gets all cloudy in there. I don't know. It's kind of neat. It's just a little novelty. So, and you know, you'd be able to see how much juice you have left in there when you use the acrylic cap on it as well. And the acrylic's very, very thick. So, you know, maybe you might be able to get away with using something a little more volatile than what you would typically use in an acrylic tank. You know, if you're going to use something like Pluid or like a heavy, heavy menthol or citrus, I would definitely recommend using the stainless steel cap. But... that's really my only complaint about the device, though. Like I said, it's just the air holes are a little bit too low, in my opinion. So, you know, you will have some issues maybe with juice leaking out of the air hole on you. But other than that, it's good. If you keep it upright, you're not going to have any issues. So. There you go. So that's the fuse from UDC. You know, it's a dripper hybrid, which is a cool idea. I dig that. I wish you could go down to 18350 with it. 500 is pretty compact. You know, 650 is real big. You don't want to do low ohm dual coil on an 18350 anyway, but I have found myself using the 350s more often in combination with drippers, specifically the single coil ones. But anyway, that's all personal preference stuff, so that doesn't really matter. It's a decent device. It's built well. Machining's good on it. I didn't have any, you know, there weren't any scratches on it when it got here like I've had with some other mods. You know, everything's well put together. The threading is clean on it. Like I said, my only real gripe is just that the air holes are a little bit too low, so. So there you have it. That is the Fuse Hybrid from Underdog Customs, UDC.